Hi, I'm Pastor Ken, and once again, this is God Has a Word for You. Good to be back and gather around the Word of the Living God. Well, this series of messages is entitled, or it's a question, going to hell? Well, no, the pastor's not cussing, but certainly this is a word that's used on the lips of many people in their rages of profanity and cussing. But no, hell is a real place, and we want to get into that this time to make sure that we understand the importance that Jesus puts on this place, this very real place, where a lot of people are going to end up. Certainly, if my question to you was going to hell, well, you'd probably say no. But do you have your tickets paid up to go to heaven? You see, it's either heaven bound or hell bound. Which is your final destination? Certainly, to be heaven bound, you have to have put your trust in Jesus. So the only way to not to go to hell is to put your trust in Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. If you are destined to hell, well, you just simply do nothing. See, you can't be neutral here. You have to put your trust in Jesus Christ or your destination is hell. Well, we're going to talk about this place called hell. And certainly when I was accepting Christ as my personal Lord and Savior, one of the primary things foremost on my mind was, you know, I love myself. Of course, most of us do. We want to do the best for ourselves, and we care about ourselves. So I was concerned about where I was going to spend the rest of my eternity. And you see, it has to do also with believing what God says in His Word. And certainly I believe in the inerrancy of the Word of God. So I believe what Jesus had to say about this place called hell. And I certainly don't want to end up there. It's interesting to note that studies show that 90% of people in this world believe in a heaven, while less than 50% believe in an eternal hell. What does that say? You see, you have to believe what Jesus says in His Word. It takes faith to believe in heaven or hell. Well, that's the first step. Faith in the Lord Jesus Christ and what He has to say. Jesus said that my words that I speak are both spirit and life. So this series of messages is to bring to light to our memories, put it foremost in our mind, refresh us, so to speak, those of us that are in the church, about this place called hell and why it is so urgent that we get the message of the kingdom out to the world, to our loved ones, to our friends who are not even thinking about the eternal destiny. Because you will either wind up in heaven or you're going to wind up in hell. That's a fact according to the Word of God. And speaking about those people that are in church, the important thing is that you have a relationship with God. You see, come on, let me talk about this a little bit. A relationship with God means that you have come into the body of Christ, come into the household of faith, and now He has complete jurisdiction of your life. You see, He is now Lord of your life as well as Savior. And this is very important because now we are following after Jesus and we are getting all of our instructions from Him. And as we listen to Him and obey Him, then we're going to end up in the right place. But there's a lot of people that are in the four walls of the church, inside these beautiful edifices, and they're lost at home. Isn't that a horrible thing? In front of the Word of God on a weekly basis, maybe more than that, and still haven't taken to heart what God is saying in His Word. Well, if we don't take to heart what God is saying, we can be in the church and still hell bound. We have to make up our minds to be followers of Christ, listening and doing everything that He says, at least attempting to, and we will end up in the right place. Heaven is my home. Where's yours? We're going to continue with this message. Going to hell? I'm Pastor Ken. God has a word for you. If you haven't yet accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, let's do so right now with this prayer of salvation. Pray after me. but it's more important that you're sincere and that you believe it in your heart. Father God, I believe your word, and your word says in Romans chapter 10 that if I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe with my heart that God has raised him from the dead, that I will be saved. So right now, I put my trust in you, Jesus Christ, as my personal Lord and Savior. I admit that I'm a sinner and I need God in my life. I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God who went to the cross to wash away my sin. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. If you prayed that prayer, I want you to email us and let us know, because right now you're saved and the angels in heaven are rejoicing. And do yourself a huge favor and pray that God would lead you to a Bible-believing church where you can continue to grow in grace. God bless you.